Welcome to this.
Well, I appreciate you taking the time to come out and talk to us today, bud. Just want to get, you know, you've been farming for 40 years and you got 1,100 acres out here.
Orion was introduced to us on this farm back in 2008, and our first test on that.
Of course, one of our main concerns is fuel cost. Mm-hmm. And with the fuel cost rising and the surcharges that we have to add to our contract, you know, we still need to cut costs, but one of the biggest things that we found with your lubricating system is, you know, we've tried it now for 6 months and it saved us pretty much 14.5% on fuel cost.
Okay.
And
how'd you guys come up with those? How'd you come up with those numbers?
Well, we did a 4 month study, 2 months without the product, and then 2 months afterwards, and then we got our numbers, and it come up. I guess after the cost of the product, we're saving about 42 cents a gallon on fuel. Mm-hmm.
All right, back in 2011, we were running low on fuel during eliminations. One of our friends gave us 5 gallons of his fuel to use. We put it in our truck, you know, and didn't think anything of it. Now, our truck runs pretty darn consistent, usually within 2 hundredths or less of what we dial it. And we dumped Bob's fuel in there and went out, and we went 7 hundredths quicker than what we had dialed. I can't remember the exact dial, but I do know it was 7 hundredths quicker. We were all pretty amazed by that because we didn't change anything. We didn't change the fuel. We didn't change the timing. We changed nothing. We dumped fuel into the fuel tank that was treated with Orion 5000. We did not know this at the time. We asked him, why did our truck run faster? Because of your fuel. It's the only thing we did different. He told us he put a little nitro in it. I guess he figured that Orion was a big secret at the time. Well, a couple months later, he came clean with us and told us it was Orion, and that another one of our racing buddies was introduced him to it. And I went and talked to him, and we got our own bottle of Orion 5000. And we treated everything. We treated the engine, we treated the fuel, we treated the transmission, and we treated the rear end. As soon as we treated the fuel, we noticed that it wouldn't build temperature anymore on the low speed. We had to lean it out 2 full flats on the low speed. For you alcohol injected guys, you understand what a jump that is. Now, that's just by adding the Orion to it. The engine, we were running a 406 at the time. Should have probably freshened it up after 2 seasons, but we didn't. We went 3 seasons on it, again, running the Orion in it. When we did tear that 406 down, it looked amazing. There was maybe 2 scratches on a couple of the bearings. Other than that, it was hardly through the break-in metal on the bearings. It was unlike anything we'd ever seen before. The cam bearings were like new, the main bearings, the rod bearings, all of it. Anyways, we put it in the transmission. Like I said, the tranny, we're on three seasons now. It's a cone-built power glide. We've broken a converter in it and had the tranny guy clean it out, go back through it. Anyways, we're still running the original clutches that came from it when it was brand new from Cone 3 seasons ago. Our transmission guy, the one who rebuilds everything, said he doesn't understand how it's lasted so long. The only thing we could figure is maybe it's got something to do with the Orion. We've never had a tranny last this long either. It's currently behind a 434, which is making somewhere in the neighborhood of 750 horsepower. So, you know, it's doing its job. We treated the rear end, and we're also on to the third or maybe even fourth season, I can't remember. Third season with the rear end. 4 9-inch with the nodular housing, 580 gears in it. And so far, we've never had a single issue with that rear end ever. It's got the original gears in it. We're running, the truck weighs about 2,400 pounds. With a driver in it, and we're running low 120 60-foot times. So, you know, it's getting right out of the hole. It's putting a lot of stress on the rear end. The only thing I can figure is it's got to be the Orion 5000 that's making it live this long, because, you know, been around racing for quite a little while, and normally parts don't last this long. You know, we're not made of money. We don't have the highest top-dollar parts. So to have stuff last as long as it does is pretty amazing, and it's really good for us because we're on a low budget, you know. So, Orion 5000, it's the shit.